Before Apple created the Pro Display XDR, they created this, the Apple Cinema Display. So I've been working in technology for years, and over that time I've collected some really interesting items, and this is probably one of the coolest pieces of retro technology that I've ever owned. This is the OG Pro Display XDR, there's no other way to label it. This is a tray 2-inch LCD display. The Cinema Display and the Apple Pro Display XDR have the same price tag. When this came out in the year 2000, it had a price tag of $4,000 US. And today with inflation, that's come out to about $5,600 US, which of course is the same price as a Pro Display XDR. I really love the pinstripe style of it, which was to match the Powermac G4 of that time period. And because I love symmetry, that would be a style that I'm totally into. And even though the bezels are huge, I think it's just an absolutely really cool design. So something really notable about the display is its stand. These stands are prone to breaking. They're made out of this see-through plastic material. And while it's very pretty, you can definitely feel the fragileness of it. Apple's construction quality has improved so much over the past 2 decades. It also has 2 USB ports on the back of it. However, they are 1.1 speed, so I probably wouldn't be using them for much. They would be useful, however, for, I suppose, for charging a mouse or a keyboard or even your phone. So this has actually been inside my closet for a few years now. I just wanted to take it out and show it to you. It was just a really interesting acquisition. I have to be honest with you, I actually got it for free, which is super cool. And yeah, I just haven't been able to figure out what to do with it, but at the same time, I don't want to throw it out because it is so cool. So one thing I noticed was that I wasn't able to control the brightness on the MacBook Pro like all the other Apple monitors, but thankfully this specific monitor does have hardware buttons on it for you to control the brightness. So I really wanted to see how color accurate this monitor was. Obviously it came out a long time ago, so it wouldn't have DCI or REC 2020, but I was really hoping it would do REC 709, which is obviously the broadcast standard. So I attached my color calibrator to it, which is the i1 Pro Plus, and I went ahead and calibrated the monitor. And surprisingly, it got very close to perfect calibration for REC 709. Now, it wasn't 100%, but like it was like in the 90s. So it was like 98%. Like it was really within striking distance. So that was really impressive. So the monitor actually isn't very bright. It's about 180 nits at its brightest. However, what most people don't realize is actually when you're grading for film and TV or even photography, for film it's between 80 to 100 nits depending on what color profile you're using. And for, you know, design and publishing, it's about 120 nits. So a lot of people actually do a lot of grading with very high brightness settings, which is actually not how you're supposed to do it. So while this wouldn't be the best experience for just general day-to-day tasks, it actually is bright enough for something like color grading if you were to go into REC 709. And just looking at the monitor, it's really vivid for such an old display, like it's incredible, like no wonder it was so expensive back then. Another thing I noticed is that it actually has pretty good viewing angles. From, you know, extreme angles, you're actually, the content is viewable. Now it does distort, which is very funny because that's actually been a criticism of the new Apple Pro Display XDR, is that when you're looking at it from an off angle, people have noticed that the colors aren't perfect. So it seems to be a pattern with Apple throughout the era, because it's the same thing with this. But it is pretty cool that in a time where there was like TFT displays and that was before IPS panels, that this really did have good viewing angles, which I think is super cool for such an old display. Another cool thing I actually noticed is that the base of it's so wide that you would actually be able to slip your MacBook Pro in if you wanted to use it in clamshell mode. I have the 15 inch and it actually fit in pretty perfectly. So one thing I did notice though is that when I did close the MacBook Pro is that everything turns off, including this monitor. There was no way to wake it up with my external mouse or keyboard. So if you actually were to get one of these for yourself and use it with a laptop in clamshell mode, you'd have to use a third party app like Caffeine or something else to keep the system awake. So this actually uses a very special connector called ADC, which stands for Apple Display Connector. And this came around the time of the Powermac G4 and the G4 Cube. And essentially, this connector would power the display, the video, and USB ports all from one cable. However, obviously this is not a supported standard anymore. So Apple did create like an external power brick. And I actually had to get that for this setup. And it's really huge and clunky, like that's a huge power supply or whatever. I don't know what PCB is in there, but it's huge. And obviously I had that running to DVI, and then I had to get a DVI to USB-C converter so I could plug it into my MacBook Pro. Will I actually use it? I don't know. I mean, here's the thing, it's not even full HD. It's just such a cool display. It's like I cannot throw this out. That's the thing. Since we've been in lockdown, I've been really like throwing a lot of things out and really, you know, de-hoarding. but I really can't bring myself to get rid of this or even sell it. I was considering selling it. So yeah, I think it's going back into the closet, but it was a really cool evening to take it out and play with it and see what it could do. I actually, you know, color calibrated it for the first time. I actually found out how capable it was. So yeah, this has been a really interesting project for me, just to take it out and have a look at it. And I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. If you do, please subscribe and leave a comment to let me know, because I can do more videos about these really cool pieces of interesting technology. I've done a video about my iBook, my first ever MacBook Pro that I've ever owned. I've done a video about that too, so you can check those out on the channel. But other than that, I hope you guys are staying safe and well, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.